started. I think some people are going to be a little late getting back from the break, and that's perfectly okay. So we have two additional interesting presentations this afternoon from two distinguished guests, and we appreciate them coming and taking time to share with us today. Our first one is titled An Overview of Digital Textbooks in Japan by Professor Yoshida Masami from Chiba University in Chiba, Japan. So welcome, and you're welcome to begin.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Yoshida. Today, I'd like to introduce about the most largest ICT-related problem. This is happening on the school education. Oh, I need to keep that up. Yeah. It's covered elementary school, secondary.
Also, we have the huge number of the students, each grade, about 1 million to 1.5 million students exist in the country. And recently, our government changed the strategy, not only the providing the paper style of the textbook, but also they are trying to distribute the digital style of the textbook. So that today, I would like to have the chance to introduce the situation in Japan, how government try to distribute the digital textbook. It's a word cloud. Actually, I wrote the paper and sent to the TCU. But I found, unfortunately, this year, they didn't issue any proceedings. So that my paper was disappeared. It's OK. But this is a word cloud of my paper. So my presentation includes the material, the textbook, and the digital, and the school education. So in this case, we don't cover the higher education. So before that, I must introduce my colleague. He's worked for the most leading textbook company in Japan. Actually, in Japan, we have the 42 published company exist. But this company is the most leading company in Japan. And also, today, we would like to concentrate on this company to introduce the media product. Introduction. Digital textbook. There are two styles. One style is for the teacher. Another one is for the student. You know? But there are big differences. You know? So at this moment, everywhere in the country, so the school education is like a free of charge, free education. In the free education, government must give the free textbook. Okay? This is based on the teaching materials. Also, sometimes students need to make their own exercise. They go to some bookshop and buy some training and exercise book. Student must pay. In terms of the textbook, you know, if the digital content is close to the paper textbook, maybe government must prepare the budget. But if the digital materials is close to the student side, student must pay, parents must pay. You know, this is a problem. Because recently, the education was changed from the teacher center to student center. You know, we must prepare the more learning materials than instructional materials. But thinking about like a law, we must mind about strong barrier about free education, even in Japan. This study covers the summary. Also, as I said, we have the 42 published company. Some of the company, they made the syndication to exchange the idea and try to cut the cost or something like that. But anyway, utilization it's not so different across the company. But utilization is different across the subject. Today, if I have the time, I will directly introduce about the case of like science and English, you know. In case of the e-learning and some other platform, they use the same platform. But in this case, you know, target is huge. Budget also the huge. Project also huge. Based on the opinion of the user. User meaning the in-service teacher. You know, we developed a different based on the subject. So that even the same company, science, digital textbook, and language, you know, like English textbook, digital textbook, they're totally different appearance because the request of the teacher is different. Variety of the digital textbook. This is like a situation of our cases. I would like to introduce the one example of the digital textbook for teacher's edition. Okay? So in this company, they use HTML5. You know, some company use a Flash, but this company selected the HTML5, you know, because the thinking of the situation of the like infrastructure in the school. They can provide some hardware, but sometimes they are difficult about using the software, something like that. So that they select the HTML5 and Java. Also, maybe this is only in Japan. Do you have this kind of the machine? In Japan, all the school, they have this interactive whiteboard, IWB. It's very expensive like this. This is like close to the big touch panel. But the big touch panel has a server. Also, the server is connected to the student by wireless. You know, student have the PC or tablet, something like that. So the teacher can communicate with the student via tablet, something like that. It's an interactive whiteboard. It's extremely effective to use the teacher's edition. Price is also very important. So they set a very specific way to decide the price. DVD, Sonmon Sampan Bats, you know, per textbook, one-time contract, you know. In our country, we developed the textbook by using the 10 years, you know. After the revision of the curriculum, that is the beginning of the making the study about the next curriculum. And spending the 10 years, we conducting the next curriculum and the textbook. So that once school buys the DVD, they can use the 10 years. But also the company tried to improve some minor update in every year. So if they don't mind about the minor update, they can use 10 years with Sonmon Sampan Bats, okay? But also the download side, usually the only 10% of the school use the download side. Also the download side is a 1 year contract, but adaptable to the update, okay? That's the difference. And function. All the digital textbook include some basic function, like a display, enlarge contents, change font, read aloud with speed control, transparency, black and white reversal, spotlight, focusing, and marker. Like almost the same as the word processor. And the next is interactive, overwriting, hide and move, whiteboard. Link to animation and video, web link, link to the dictionary, visual contents, list, additional exercise. Also the customers, is possible the customers rearrange the pages. So the most important thing is textbook. All the textbook, paper textbook, you know, is screened by the government. That's why I mentioned that in our country we spend 10 years to develop the next textbook. So quality is extremely high, you know. All the textbook is the best quality, no mistake, and suitable to be the show some standard to all the school in the country, okay? textbook is a standard and no mistake. It's very important. We spend a lot of time. Also, the textbook is different from the other country. In case of the other country, in the textbook, only two or three people write the textbook. But in our country, usually the 10 to 30 people writing together, including university professor, school teacher, no, and expert in the educational institute as well. No, we have no difference, no, between the professor and the school teacher. No, we are fair, so that we discuss and try to develop the best textbook. In each textbook have the 10 to 30 writer. Okay, so that's a very important thing. And this is a digital textbook have the more information than paper type. Also, the totally compatible. For example, in the science, there is a science experiment for the student. And one picture, only one picture. But in this case, this same situation, same people, same apparatus move. Okay? That's very important. Very strong compatibility to the curriculum. Okay? Do you want to see some example? Maybe the better to show that. Okay? Liaona? Chinchin lo lambak na, ani chapo numpan son loi pesip na. The digital textbook ao numpan sam loi kwa na. Ko lambak, liaona kap. Ora. My hand tam chai mai, ko lambak na. Okay, the next is an example of the science. Okay, I'm sorry that we cannot cover all the menu because of the low resolution. Like this is a science based on the paper textbook. You know, appearance is the same as the paper. But if we move the mouse, you know, there's some to put enlarge. So the text will change to the digital signage, okay? Also the, for example, the, this is a quiz. Can you answer the quiz? Or one cell going to the two cell. Like finally two cell. For my logic, na. There. I need two group law. I need my chai. I need chai, chai my. I need my China. I need to go to China. And, Tukton. No, Bevni. This is, you know, this is very important, no? Like a teacher do everything. Also, the teacher ask some student and the move also possible. Also, the student have the terminal as well, you know? So, teacher asking the student, one student, you move. The student move, something like that. You know, this is like an interactive type. And next, me Ryan.
And the video.
You know, in the textbook, only the picture. But in this case, move and showing the way to how to handle the apparatus and the experiment.
Okay?
Sorry, pass a yip na. Maybe pass a tie. So the Japanese.
Like this.
So the quality is very important, but the compatibility is highly sophisticated because the same company.
その後、根の先端を取り出し、水ですすぎます。
このように塩酸
処理をした玉ねぎの根の先端をスライドガラスに乗せ、絵付き針で軽く潰します。染色液を垂らします。3分間ほど置いたら、ゆっくりとカバーガラスをかけます。 プレパラートを2つに折ったろ紙の間に挟み、カバーガラスの中央部を指で静かに押して根を押しつぶします。
Okay, this is one of the examples. You know, there are many contents inside the textbook. You know, for example, the another pages like this. This is animation. Also, the we can stop, we can move, something like that. So the many functions exist based on the you know, original textbook. Okay. Another example is English is easy to understand. Diana, Valeo. This is also the part of the textbook, but the appearance is not the same as the textbook, because this is based on the strategy of the English teacher. They asked their way to involve. So for example, the click.
Does Haruki live near a beach?
Yes, he does. He lives in Gold Coast.
So that we can select the person, silent.
Only
does another
person. Does he go to the beach
speak
every day?
And speak Hong Kong.
But he goes there on weekends.
Something what does like he that. Do there?
Like this. So this is based on the strategy of the teacher. Also the...
He doesn't, but he goes there on weekends.
What does he do there?
Japanese
he
translation,
runs,
something
swims,
like that. We can select.
And surfs
also,
with
we
his
can
friends.
Control the speed. Okay. The next is like a picture card. Diana, Anicha. Okay. So like a picture card. So we can use a picture card method. Something like that.
Does Haruki live near a beach?
Yes, he does.
Like this, based on the favorable strategy of the English teacher, they asked the company. Company prepared the function. Okay? So the time restriction, do you want to? Resolution might be not too high. Okay. We are not. This is a case study of the Japanese school, secondary school, first grader, seventh grader, Matayamuno. Long day, Matayon, tea even.
お願いします。
Sorry for Japanese language.
Like
this. Teacher used the traditional classroom, and also sometimes the student have the terminal. And beside the traditional blackboard, there is an interactive whiteboard to manage and communicate with the student.
一番左上かな?
At this moment, all the Japanese public school have this machine. At least one set. But many of the schools have their machine. Maybe the one grader, one set, something like that. Like this. So the digital textbook, is using in the communication in the environment. Yeah, or not deep, deep, or not deep, deep.
Deep. Ah, so.
Any student, Kian, no? Student, you know, they made a drawing. You know, based on the opinion of the teacher, student active. Also, the teacher shows us some direction and the answer on the blackboard.
ピンクですか。はい。どんな色分けにしましたか。なんで笑ってる。どんな色分けにしましたか。
うん。I think that this is very important for the Asian people. You know, in case of the Asian student like your student, if we give them the chance to discuss, no, no one talk.Just silent. They are shy. Even in Japan, the same. But once we put some tool between the people, you know, we can talk. You know, there are such kind of the technique. Even in Japan, for example, in the brainstorming in Western country. But in Japan, we have the KJ method. You know, something like that. By using the paper, by using the tool. That will enhance the communication among the students.
はい、みんなね図形で分けてくれたんですが、
Okay, sorry, the, maybe the, I have a data. That if you want, would like, the, I will give you the. So anyway, the later on. So the back to the presentation. The next is the student version. You know, there are two styles of the student version. One is a like a service, you know, teacher's edition, and.Additional service, you know, this is a strategic, that I said. Teacher's edition is close to the free of charge textbook. But the student edition, totally student edition, is close to the, some workbook in the, you know, usual bookstore. So that this company providing the two style. One style is like additional service of the teacher's version. And another one is totally the different version.Also the possible, in case of the student version, it's not covered at all. It's not a workbook. It's a digest of the teacher's edition. So the summarizing the so far, the, you know, this is teacher's version.
Yeah.
Close to the interactive whiteboard. And there is a server, you know, provided by the download and the, DVD. The another way is like a student, their own student version. One way is like a buy, download. Another way is like a service of the teacher's edition. Also, the, we have the another digitalized content that is a worksheet database. The people in the published company,They said, you know, this service is very strong, you know. Many of the teachers want to use this. So they're like exercise sheets, something like that. At this moment, published company, only one published company have the 5,000 seat for elementary. Also the another 5,000 seat for the lower secondary school. You know, all the...Worksheet is compatible to the textbook because they developed the textbook. Also, the writer is coming from the textbook people. Okay? Also, the selectivity rate, about only, I don't know, maybe the 22% of the school, they bought. You know, we are very sorry that our school is very poor at this moment. You know, maybe poorer than Thailand. You know, budget of the school is very small. Nevertheless, you know,Only 22% they want to use. Price is somun numpam baht per year per subject. In school, the many grade, the many subject. So the school cannot cover the, all the subject. You know. The next is an example. Sometimes they use...And the download, they use a database and download the PDF. But also that they are providing the file of the word processor. So the teacher can modify. Also some company, actually this is a Tokyo Shoseki company, they're providing the automatic evaluation system, OCR. You know? But usually the OCR for science and mathematics is impossible. But they developed their own OCR to evaluate the scientific formula as well. You know? Also that they're providing some automatic evaluation system. The next, audio-visual materials. They also have the audio-visual, the many titles, thousands of the titles. Also the price, like this. So the they have the web service, is 1 year contract. Also the they have the data service put in the server, you know. So the, I must say that some system, school system, public school system in Japan. You know, we have the elementary school and the secondary school and the high school. Elementary and the secondary school is a school of city. Okay? So the one city, like Bangkok, decide we use this textbook. All school use the same textbook. Okay? So the, in this case, educational board of the city make the contract with the company and put the data in the server in the educational board. But in the high school, each high school is under the province. So the each high school can decide the textbook. It's our public system. So that each high school must make the contract with the published company. Then factor in the school. This is the statistics. You know, quite difficult to get the statistics. You know, my counterpart is the executive director of the media production in the published company. But he don't know much about it because our Ministry of Education didn't disclose the detail of the statistics. But this is a part of the statistics at this moment. So the not so many. Almost half of the like elementary and junior secondary, they introduce. Actually, all of them want to use. But because of the limitation of the budget in the school, you know, if this digital textbook is part of the paper textbook, government must provide in the older school. It's the responsibility of the government. But at this moment, because of the law, you know, textbook is like additional materials. So each school must prepare the budget. It's a burden for the older school. But anyway, many of the school using at this moment. Also, they discuss under the discussion, but in the newspaper, here comes the news about from 2018, after 2 years, so all over the school, and we'd like to introduce a textbook, including the student version. Also, the many of the people asking the ministry to change the regulation. So the benefit to use the digital textbook. Concrete explanation. So the one of the remarkable effect of using the digital textbook is the eye of the student. You know, usually student look down and reading the textbook paper one. But after using the digital one, many of the students look in front of them, you know. Their eyesight was changed. And also the increase the concentration on the main point of the discussion. Introduce a new mode of the explanation via moving arrow on the screen. Introduce a dynamic iconic view to embed arrows. This involves the psychographic image of moving action and the changing and the depth of the focus. tablet with a sensor can introduce for real-time analysis. Augmented reality AR function can also be included. Have you ever heard of AR? Yes. Pokemon Go. Yes. You know Pokemon Go. The camera of the mobile terminal, and sometimes coming the Pokemon inside, like this. So this is real. Textbook and tablet over the textbook. Here comes the Pokemon Go. Now already can be used. Okay? The augmented reality is real. Actually, this is based on the Tokyo Society. They providing the some progressive function into the normal paper textbook. Pokemon Go, okay. So not only the benefit, but also that we must mind about problematic aspect of the digital textbook. Learning becomes standardized, okay? Learning is only focused on the getting the right answer. Because always, after all the digitalized, answer should be prepared in advance, Also, try to use some automatic method. So that we introduce the student to fixed answer lesson mode. So we must mind about some problem. Because the opportunity to write disappears, student ability to write. Oh, yes. Many of the teachers said student need to write during the lesson. Not only the see and the view, something like that. Student need to write to develop their knowledge and the competencies. Okay? And fourth, communication between the teacher and the student stop sometimes. It is difficult to judge the answer with plural solutions such as proof, something like that. It's very important. So, we cannot include all the things in the automatic. It must have some talent of the teacher and the expertise of the teacher to take care of the student. Immediate feedback, namely the game sense, disturbs the development of the intellectual thinking. Yes. It's not a game. It's a real learning. Students must know the real learning. And program learning does not improve the intellectual thinking and the decision making. Yes, this also. Around 20 years ago, there is an argument about the effect of the media. So now, well known in the field of the educational technology. Media will not provide the effect of the effect to the student. Students cannot change their achievement, Maybe media can improve the motivation and the involvement of the student, but once we put the media, student point of the examination will not grow, okay? So we must mind about the effect of the media. Actually, lesson style, lesson designing is more important than using the media. Anticipated challenge, okay, challenge. Yes, as I mentioned, we need to change the regulation to be include the digital textbook in the law. Infrastructure, yes, congestion control. In the classroom technique, teacher said, okay, you access this side, student, all the student access. Immediately, here comes the congestion control. Okay, not did. No. So congestion control. So this textbook company, they're using the CDN, Content Delivery Network, like edge computing, like Akamai system. So to avoid the congestion control. Nevertheless, in the usual case, in the elementary and the secondary grade, once the teacher says something, all the students do the same thing. It's troublesome. If even only the 2 or 3 minutes interval during the lesson, that disturbs and decreases the concentration of the student. We must mind about the stability of the system. So that's a very important thing. And next, law. Oh, law. Yes, copyright problem. Also that. Japan is very strict about the copyright, everywhere. Intellectual property is very strict,
in Japan, all the people buy the CD with copyright, you know. In Thailand, all the CDs are Roy Gao Gao. It's a totally different, okay? So meeting of the investigate communication for the digital textbook student edition. Reluctantly, the proposed that the cost of the digital textbook should be covered by the guardian. No? Parents must pay the cost of the student. Maybe you will have the same thing in the future. No? Many teachers said, now is a student center. We must prepare the learning materials. If so, all the parents must pay for the digital. But the school prepared the textbook is free of charge. This is a part of the instructional materials. In the future, we can ask the government to cover the cost of the teacher's edition. So that is the argument in the future. Oh, future review. It's not the end. Sorry. There's a future difference in the academic explanation among the country. Oh, the time? Okay, okay. There's a future difference in the academic explanation among the country. Yes. Actually, now many people discussing about the open educational resource, the MOOC. You know, once someone develops, we share the same thing, something like that. But actually, we already made many studies, you know, like the contents of the elementary first grade are nearly the same across the world. But from the many difficult things after the second grade, you know. So the educational content is different across the country. We know. We already made many studies, you know, because, you know, for example, the China and Japan, the same Chinese character, you know. So in Japan, we use the triangle is a three angle. In the Chinese, you know, three sides, something like that. You know, even the same Chinese character use, but the explanation is totally different across the country. So it's difficult maybe to exchange the contents. You know, it must have some expertise to transfer the contents. So the appropriateness of the visual content is not adaptable among the Also this one, you know. I used to have the many chances to contribute to some developing country as a JICA expert. But each country should have their own content. It's not foreign content. Because the culture and the climate is totally different. It is difficult to extend the copyright, especially, this problem. You know, in the textbook, I said we have the 30 writer. Also, each person have the intellectual property. In addition, if we put the audio and the visual, you know, each content have the intellectual property. It's quite hard to, you know, fulfill all the clearances. It can contribute to Japanese language. Oh. Yes, sometimes the Japanese language for the student in the Japanese class. This is experience. Then, what is the future of the exchange, the digital content across the country? It's a real idea. At this moment, this reading company have the international relation, not the content sharing, not the content, you know. So the qualified printing for textbook is the quality of the, you know, mode, media mode inside the textbook. Also the Vietnam, technical transfer of the textbook development system. You know, development of the digital materials, policy of MOE for the digital textbook. You know, many of them under the support of the Japanese government, you know, overseas development assistance, ODA project as well. Like this, not only the communication of the contents as well, not only the contents, but also the we must mind about the production system and qualified development, way of the qualified development is maybe the very concrete issue for the future international communication. Also, this company also have the offshore production in the China, Vietnam, and Taiwan. In this case, also that we have the chance to communicate with a foreign country. In the future challenge, that I mentioned, we must prepare the space for free lighting, you know, like this. Also, the, in the future, like using the cyberspace and the cloud, we could have the chance to communicate with communicate among the teacher in the all over the country, something like that. It's possible, but the problem is all the time they are already standard because of the security reason. It's sometimes difficult to communicate among the people. Also, sometimes personal information that student disclose is a problem. So that is a burden for our project. Okay, thank you very much. If you have the question, feel free to ask me. Thank you very much. Now, so the digital technology is also the limited. So the once people develop the, some educational content in the Coursera or the other project, appearance also the same. No, looks like similar. But my point is this is based on the printed textbook and the compatibility is 100%. Coursera is intent to share the content without any basis, okay? That's totally different.
Oh, you mean that this one is for the printout?
No, based on the printed textbook.
On the textbook.
Yes, paper textbook.
Yeah.
No. So the compatibility between the digital textbook and the print paper textbook is 100%, no problem. Mm-hmm. But you mentioned about the Coursera is the one course for share.
Yeah.
The, what is the compatible?
But they also have... You
know, sometimes if I'm using the Coursera, uh-huh. I must change my lesson to adapt the Coursera.
Yes.
It's a totally different.
Okay.
Okay.
Understand that.
Do you have another question? Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you very much. Very interesting presentation. Okay, our second presentation of the afternoon session is titled iScale Smart Classroom by Associate Professor Kuntani Manirattana from Chulalongkorn University in Bangkok, Thailand, and certainly welcome her for taking time to join us this afternoon. Give her a couple minutes to get technology set up here and we'll get started.
Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, everybody. My name Can you hear me? good afternoon. Sorry. good afternoon. Can you hear me? Are you okay? Yes, okay, thank you. My name is Kuntini. Please note that I am not an from the Faculty of Education. I come from the Faculty of Engineering. So I have to say that my approach may be a little more, let's say, have less theories. So I would like to ask your pardon if I mix up something. I'm going totally free science with a lot less scholars than usual, unlike other speakers that you have experienced so far. So I came here as a representative of our engineering educational initiative units, which we're trying to develop our teaching to ensure that our students graduate with qualities. To make sure this one, have you ever known this gentleman? No? Actually, this is the first time I saw his picture like this when I searched for in the Creative Commons. I have some work with a robot, so I have to say that he's quite special. His name is Isaac Asimov. He is a science fiction writer who specializes in the robots. But what I'm talking today is not about robots at all. It's about one of the short stories, the one that is written almost 60 years ago. I never know, have you ever heard of this novella, Profession? Yes? No? No? Okay. This is, he theorized then that's what will happen if you can download information directly into the brain. So what's happened? A student can play all around at the start of the elementary age. He can go to some office, download the language package. They can read and write. When they come of age, they can go to the job office, download the package, and go to work. Well, I think it's quite interesting, even though the concept behind this one is the learning is not as important as to learn how to learn. In this case, I have to say that he didn't mention anything to do with the skills or aptitude or something like that. So it's not quite cover what we are thinking about. But what happened here is that he says he can get rid of schools. There's no need to have a physical school. And if you look at our disruptive innovation in higher education or other level of education that we have seen so far, I have to say that some kind of list that I did here have something a lot to do with the information technologies. If you think about the augmented realities, I see a very nice 3D pictures of all sorts of biologies, very, very complex. When you have e-learnings, you have an online learnings, you have a MOOCs. So I think what will happen in near future or not so near future, 10 years, 20 years from now, of course, I'm going to retire by then. But in this case, I think it's quite interesting to see what will happen. Are you going to get rid of classroom altogether? We can stay at home, join the virtual classrooms, and then we have no need to travel. No need to get a dorm or something like that. What do you think? Good? Not good? Well, just thinking, why we are still going to sport match, right? We can watch the match, like football or Euro or something or whatever, at home very comfortably, but we're still going to the stadiums. I think this is the experience that counts. We are socializing animals at all. So it means that after all, I don't think that the classroom is not going to go, but it may change. I try to look through some type of smart classrooms that are employed around the world. For example, this one from the Samsung. They represent a smart classroom. You have a lot of technologies, big screens, individual screens, Wi-Fi and other things like this. However, I have to say that to me it looks pretty, at least for this picture, it looks pretty uniform, too uniform. And then if you look at the classroom of the future, you can download these ones and see from the YouTube quite easily. There's a lot of description of what they envisioned about the future classrooms almost 10 years ago. And this, a lot of this has come into reality. Maybe I have to go back a little bit to our educational philosophies. The Faculty of Engineering, Chulalongkorn University, has committed ourselves to what we call Education 4.0 about 2 years ago, which I don't know whether it's fortunate or unfortunately, the 4.0 is coming into a very trendy world in Thailand right now about all of those industries and Thailand 4.0 or whatever. But what we mean then is that we want our students, when they graduate, they must be innovators. They don't have to work for themselves, but they must be able to see users. They must be able to see problems that users experience and then solve them. So, of course, easier is easier said than done. How we can make sure that the students have that ability? So we more or less have a really good chance coming into an engineering educational framework, CDAO. This is an international consortium. It's not accreditation board. It's just a framework that we voluntarily subscribe to. The CDAOs come from four words. It's conceived, designed, implement, and operate. That is the systems that engineers regularly do. However, engineering schools usually do one, design. We didn't conceive. It means that we didn't look at the users. We get the specification somewhere, design an equipment that fit the specs, and that's it. We didn't see whether it can become a reality, whether it can be solved, or whether what will happen during its lifetime. It means that in this case, we have to do something. And I just talked with one about Professor Direk, our dean, two deans ago. It's very good time that he has a chance to overlook the construction of this building, the centenary buildings that we celebrate about a few years back. The idea of these buildings is that was meant to be innovative buildings in all aspects. The top size is for the research and collaboration with industries. The bottom size are for education. So what's happened here is that we more or less starting to have a platform for the learning corridors that we hope to integrate and be a seat of change. The idea of this one is that it has to be somewhere close together, so that the feelings, the auras, more or less, can affect the others. So it goes from the top side. The fourth, fourth, and fifth floors are new learning classrooms that we can use to conceive and design. Of course, we have to go outside as well, but this one is a nice space. The third floor is student union. Usually, the student stays there forever. The second floor is a main auditorium that you can use to record lectures. And what happened here is in the mezzanines, we have a new fab lab, or what we call mega space, with a learning injection int. We call this iDesign workspace. In this case, students can produce some prototyping very, very quickly, and then try to a little bit. And on the concourse, on the first floor, we have a large space that students can test, whole exhibition, and other things. So I hope that this is more or less integration and in confirmation with the CDAO standards. This, since today we are going to talk about the classroom, so I will eliminate all of this and concentrate on the new classroom that we have. What, of course, we do not think this one from scratch. We all, as an engineer, we highly believe in standing on the shoulders of giants. So in this case, we look around and we have a very nice thing called scale up. That is an idea of changing classrooms. You can see that in this classroom is nothing like you have when you have a rows of tables and chairs. We have a groups. Very interestingly, these are all round groups. It's all round tables. And we have lots of screens, maybe some platform, something like that. And this one, the scale, is student-centered active learning experience. So it means that in this case, the change of learning and instruction design is going to change really a lot. What happened here is that we have some problems as well, and our learning may need some other things. So we didn't fully adopt the systems, but we try to look at the elements, find the reasons behind them, and then adapt to our needs. So this is our experience timeline. We start in about 5-6 years ago when we started the classroom KMs. We found that the classrooms, traditional classrooms, has a lot of problems, both in the learning and in the management of the classrooms. How can we supply? Depends why this screen projectors more or less cover the boards, the writing area. So it's more or less incremental change. However, we found that the incremental change is no longer enough, so we started trying to do some I-scale fully. We get some mock-up on the 2013, in this case trying to show off to the alumni and get some donations or something like that. Well, actually we actually borrow the round tables that used in the Chinese banquet to do the trick, and we don't like it, so to speak, it's too large. So we change something a little bit, and finally we get the donations and get the first room ready in the first semester of 2014. It works very well, but you know how slow is our bureaucracies and the purchasing systems. So it means that it's another year by the time we get another 3 rooms up. And it's also quite success. So very nicely, the university is expanding this type of room, and we became the pilot room that our faculties can come in and have a look through. In this case, we are the room number 5 and 6 is coming this semester as well. So it's getting full, but we still have a phase to renovate a lot more, hopefully. Actually, the infrastructure is one thing. The users is more important. We ensure that there's some trainings and professional development. And we became a formal CDAO collaborators last year. Other things has to be added as well. So I have to say that this is just some of the integrated pictures we have. Okay, this is a room. What we have here is that you can see is we have tables that is not a square. Actually, it was exactly the same when I was in first grade, about a little bigger. In this case, it can be moved easily. We have a chair that can be moved easily as well. We have a lot of screens. All of those screens are mostly TVs. And we have one large screen for the projectors, but I have to say that it's not used a lot, though. And then we have the system that controls the input-output of the audio-visual signals. We have several inputs, both from the students' group. We have something like 9 TVs, so 9 inputs from the students. We can have a few more on the lecturer's platform up there. And then for the output, we use a metric system so that we can ensure that any output can get more or less we can switch between the input output freely. And also in this case, please note at the walls. The walls are all glasses. It means that you can write on them. You can put post-it note on them or something like that. And here we go. Okay, for the utilizations, we have limited number of rooms, so we have to make prioritizations, which course has the most urgent needs. What are the timetable schedulings that we need to fit in, or something like that? What we found here is that with this type of room, the long lecture is out, absolutely out. However good you are with lecturing, you cannot hold the students' attention for the whole period that we have of, it was, let's say, 1.5 hours. We have either 1.5 hour period or 3 hours. So in this case, long lecture is out. If you want to use this room, you have to have active learning. So it means that if you have a lecture, at least it has to be flipped classroom so that you have something to do in class. Everything is up to the lecturers. We give them the, more or less, we just spread the techniques on the table. Okay, you can choose whatever you like. You can develop your own. We cannot, you know the content best, and what is your students. And of course, we usually use the bring your own device. Not every student has the device, but at least you can share. Actually, the sharing is very good. Okay, this is the news in March. Have you ever seen this one? No? It's more or less in a lot of the newspapers as well. It goes like that. When there was a non-extracurriculum programs about three workshop, about 3 hours, about how to, let's say, get the girls. That's why it became a sensation. However, actually, it was something about first impression making. So, of course, they have to get some catching names in order to make news. But however, I found it's very interesting that everybody talk about how to get the girls, and nobody, no comments has it was on the room. Very interesting. So I think maybe they didn't notice it or something like that, but it may become a background. Now, how can we lecture? In the type rooms, we can do lectures like this. Hopefully, get everybody in a line in front of a screen or in front of lecturers. Well, not very good. As you say, we have to write, right, in order to learn. This setting is not going to work. If you lecture in front of the large screens, the one here, well, everybody have to turn around and look at you, they cannot write as well because the table is on the other side. So clearly, if you want to do a lecture here, it has to be short. It can be remedial lectures or something like that. Okay, and then for the lecturings, there's a problem with the system, so I have to hold this. This is a student presentation, an example of the bad one, so to speak. What happens when you are in front of the large screen? Where others look another way? No, but a few don't want to see it. But I have to say that hold attention of the student is very, very hard. Of course, it means that the learning in this class had to be something else. For example, we can have groups, hands-on works, a little work in groups that is quite nice. Of course, we expect students to walk around. If they don't understand, okay, try to find the next guy. And it means that we have to ensure that our students are up to date. Okay, in this case, she comes from the next group, actually. What happened here is that if one student knows, he can teach the others, and very soon, all the class know already. And this one, another thing, bigger groups, 5 students, we have to rearrange the tables a little bit to accommodate the students. We have a lot of table for the groups, and then lecturers, we walk around, noting the problems and checking the progress of the students. Okay. In this case, also, we can rearrange the table quite easily. In fact, we have more or less a permit. In the most standard forms, we have a space at the center. We can do a lot of reflecting, talking, and do some small, let's say, activities. Of course, we can do some group work, split the tables. We have some small groups. And then they can study, do something on their own, and get the new pictures. In this case, what they do is they study about the Wi-Fi signals. So this lecturers assign some work about the study of Wi-Fi, and then send the students out around the campus to check the strength of the Wi-Fi signals everywhere. So it means that each group of the students will have a unique problem. It's not the same as their friends, so they cannot copy. And then they have to integrate together, and they will see what happened. What are the difference between of those? Is there compatibilities, some covering? And of course, you can have some brainstormings. We have a lot of space. We have a nook and niche that we can more or less have a feeling of partitions between the groups. In this case, this is a design for the second year students in mechanical engineering. That's why I know. What this is about the first course in design. And then if we look, sorry. Sorry.
ที่สุดนะครับนะแอคทีเนี่ยการกระทำไม่ดีแอนเนาแล้วก็อยู่บนจอคอมพิวเตอร์นะครับถือว่ามี
Okay, I have to say that the sound is a little deafening. In reality, even though we have this more or less the sound absorbing walls as well, it's still quite loud. Actually, a lot of lecturers use the level of decibels to measure the success of their class. The louder, the better. We have lecturers here. The time is ticking down. Very funny. So, I have to say is that there are a lot more works that have been done in the class. Let's say, sorry. Let's have a look at some videos. I like videos. I have to say is that I use it a lot more.
รองศาสตราจารย์ดร.อังคีศิภากรนะครับตอนนี้รับหน้าที่เป็นหัวหน้าหน่วยวิศวศึกษาคณะวิศวะจุฬาสำหรับหน่วยเราเนี่ยก็มีการช่วยกันพัฒนาห้องเรียนอย่างต่อเนื่องนะครับแต่ก่อนเราก็ดูถึงห้องเรียนแบบดั้งเดิมดูซิว่าจะปรับย่อยยังไงให้มีการตอบสนองการเรียนรู้ที่แตกต่างหลากหลายได้ดีขึ้นแต่คราวนี้พอเราเห็นประเด็นแล้วว่าตัวห้องเรียนเนี่ยมันจะดีกว่าไหมถ้าเกิดจะสนับสนุนให้เด็กเนี่ยมีการเรียนรู้ร่วมกันจะดีกว่าไหมถ้าเกิดอาจารย์เนี่ยจะสามารถเข้าถึงนิสิตแต่ละคนเนี่ยได้อย่างคล่องแคล่วรวดเร็วนะครับเพื่อที่จะให้ฟีดแบ็กเขาให้เขาเรียนรู้อะไรก็มีฟีดแบ็กเขาเนี่ยมันก็น่าจะดีขึ้นมันก็จะนำมาสู่การพัฒนาที่เราเรียกว่าห้องไอสเกลห้องไอสเกลเนี่ยเราก็เรียกเหมือนว่าห้องไอก็คืออินเทอร์เนียร์นะก็คือวิศวะจุฬานี่แหละแล้วก็สเกลนี่ก็คือสตูดิโอเซ็นเตอร์นะครับแอคทีฟเลิร์นนิ่งเอ็กซ์เพรียนเพราะในห้องนี้เนี่ยเราก็มุ่งที่จะมีการเรียนรู้ที่มีสตูดิโอเซ็นเตอร์คือมีนักเรียนเป็นศูนย์กลางจริงพยายามที่จะให้อาจารย์ที่อยากจะใช้ Active Learning เนี่ยสามารถมาใช้พื้นที่ตรงนี้ได้อย่างสมเหมาะสมสะดวกในการที่เขาจะจัดรูปแบบการเรียนรู้แบบ Active Learning นั้นอันนี้ก็เป็นเป้าของการพัฒนาห้อง iScale หน่วยวิศวศึกษาของเราเนี่ยก็จะเป็นทีมนะครับทีมที่เราพยายามที่จะมาดูกันว่าตัวศาสตร์ทางด้านศึกษาศาสตร์นะครับจะถูกนำมาช่วยในการพัฒนากระบวนการเรียนรู้ในวิศวกรรมศาสตร์เราก็เลยเรียกว่าวิศวศึกษาลักษณะงานที่ผ่านมาเนี่ยเราก็จะดูในทั้งหลายๆส่วนทั้งด้านฮาร์ดแวร์ซอฟต์แวร์กับ people แน่นอนว่าฮาร์ดแวร์ที่เราคุยกันวันนี้ก็คือเรื่องของห้องเรียนเราก็ดูแลนะครับว่าจะมีการพัฒนาปรับปรุงหรือว่าเปลี่ยนโฉมไปเลยยังไงอย่างห้อง iScale เนี่ยก็เป็นการเปลี่ยนโฉมไปเลยลักษณะของซอฟต์แวร์ก็เช่นเดียวกันซอฟต์แวร์ก็คือหมายความว่าอาจารย์ที่เข้ามาสอนเนี่ยท่านก็ต้องมีแนวคิดของท่านว่าท่านจะออกแบบการเรียนการสอนยังไงออกแบบกิจกรรมยังไงตรงนี้ก็เป็นเรื่องของซอฟต์แล้วก็เรื่องของ peopleware ก็เช่นก็เรื่องของการพัฒนาศักยภาพของอาจารย์ท่านอยากจะสอนให้มีประสิทธิภาพที่ดีขึ้นสอนให้เหนื่อยแรงน้อยลงแล้วก็มีการอบรมต่างๆมีการให้ความรู้ต่างๆเพื่อที่ให้อาจารย์ท่านมีศักยภาพในการสอนที่เต็มที่ในมุมหนึ่งเนี่ยก็คือสำหรับเด็กสมัยนี้เนี่ยถ้าเกิดจะให้เขาเรียนรู้ได้ดีต้อง engage เขาทำอย่างที่จะท้าทายเมื่อให้โจทย์ที่น่าสนใจแต่สิ่งที่เราพบก็คือการท้าทายอันนึงที่เหมาะสมก็คือการที่ให้น้องๆเขาได้มาเรียนรู้ร่วมกันแล้วจะเกิดการท้าทายขึ้นโดยธรรมชาติและลักษณะของพื้นที่การเรียนรู้เนี่ยเราก็เลยอยากจะให้คนที่เรียนรู้เนี่ยเขาสามารถที่จะเข้าถึงกันได้ก็จะมีการแชร์ข้อมูลมีการท้าทายมีการเรียนรู้ร่วมกันนะครับอันนี้เป็นลักษณะของการเรียนรู้ที่เราอยากจะให้เกิดขึ้นมากขึ้น
โอเค the next one I especially cut something out I would like to you to seeThe comparisons between the old classrooms and the new classrooms. I teach one classes that has several sections. Due to the limit availabilities of the iScales, I have to teach somewhere else in a traditional classrooms using the flipped classroom systems. Well, we have a very good synchronization between the lecturers. Everybody's.Using the same materials, using same videos, check the students using the same exercise, same activity in class. We talk about this one at least 4 times a week to ensure before class, after class, and so on. What's happened here is that, unfortunately, I was ambushed by the video teams. They come up to in front of my class one day and say, I'm going to take your videos. I was very bad off that day. I mean, using dress in the dress at the back of the wardrobe or something like that. So I have to say that I cut a lot of me out. But I have to say that in this case, we have a what we call the mechanical materials. We are looking how body breaks under different type of loads. What happens when you try to pull it out, push it back, twist, bend, or do something like that. There are several modes. So what we do here is in that day, we just happen to break some shocks. The students has to predict what will happen, do it, and then see what are the difference between what they found and what they think, and then try to find, use the theories to back up what's happened or to see what's wrong with their mode of breaking up things. So this is the normal classrooms. We see that we have a row of tables around here. Students can note something down. They hardly talk with the next guy because it's difficult to more or less turn around. Usually I have to twist myself in between the rows. Not very nice. And then it's quite fun, but unfortunately they cannot pull in the groups. However, if you're in eye scales, you can see that they can see sit at different angles. They can broadcast the results to other students. There are also something like that. So I think I have to say is that even though we have everything that is the same, the environment do affect the learnings a lot. And then I would like to, in this case, we can talk easily. We can do something. And this is a broadcast to other screens. We had Apple TVs. They have even some wires.
ผมนายกฤตนัทจิราถาวงครับนิสิตคณะวิศวกรรมศาสตร์ชั้นปีที่1ครับผมอย่างห้องนี้เลยใช่ไหมครับผมรู้สึกว่ามันดีตรงที่แต่ละกลุ่มก็นั่งเป็นแหล่งของเขาแล้วก็สามารถยิงพรีเซนต์ขึ้นได้ทันทีไม่จำเป็นต้องเอากลุ่มนี้พรีเซนต์มาหน้าห้องนะแล้วก็มานั่งพรีเซนต์หน้าห้องแล้วถ้าใช้โปรเจคเตอร์เหมือนสมัยก่อนครับก็จะเหมือนกับว่าหลังห้องก็ไม่เห็นละแต่ว่าอย่างห้องตรงนี้มันเหมือนกับว่าทั่วถึงแล้วก็เวลาใช้เสียงก็คือเป็นไมค์ลอยส่งมาได้เลยผมว่ารู้สึกว่าการเรียนการสอนในห้องนี้มันทำให้ราบรื่นมากขึ้นเป็นระบบมากขึ้นแล้วก็มีความคล่องตัวมากขึ้นเพราะว่าเพื่อนพรีเซนต์อยู่ผมสามารถมองจอที่อยู่ตรงหน้าผมได้เลยรู้สึกว่าประทับใจบรรยากาศที่คอมโพสิชันต่างๆในห้องนี้มันรวมออกมาให้เรารู้สึกว่าเป็นการเรียนที่มีความร่วมมือให้ความร่วมมือกันจริงๆมีการทำงานเป็นกลุ่มจริงๆแล้วก็ได้พาร์ทิซิเพทกับกิจกรรมในคลาสจริงๆครับไม่ใช่ว่านั่งอยู่ข้างหลังแล้วก็ข้างหน้าพูดไปสี่อะไรเงี้ยรู้สึกว่าในห้องนี้ครับทุกคนมีส่วนร่วมในการเรียนการสอนจริงๆครับ
โอเค this is the first year students he take the class what we call the exploring engineering world which is the introduction to engineers they have to change the mindset a little bitfrom the science project that they used to do in the secondary schools into something more engineering. And then, something else, general education. innovative thinking is one of the most popular courses. Okay, they are juggling every year.This is what they call ultra presentation, like the Ultraman, with a time limit.
ค่ะสวัสดีค่ะชื่อนางสาวณิชาสุขันธลัมนะคะเรียนอยู่ชั้นปีที่4คณะครุศาสตร์ค่ะเป็นวิชาที่มีการเรียนการสอนแบบต่างออกไปจากที่เราเคยเรียนกันนะคะแล้วทีนี้คือตัวหนูเองเนี่ยเรียนอยู่ในคณะครุศาสตร์เนี้ยค่ะก็เลยอยากจะรู้ว่ามันจะมีวิธีสอนอย่างอื่นไหมที่นอกจากวิธีการสอนทั่วๆไปที่จะทำให้เหมือนกับว่าเด็กได้รับความรู้แล้วก็เกิดการเรียนรู้แบบอย่างเป็นประสิทธิภาพหรือว่าเป็นห้องเรียนที่ดีมากๆสำหรับการเรียนการสอนนะคะ
ก็สวัสดีครับผมชื่อไกลครับลักษณะพิสิทธิ์กุลตอนนี้เรียนอยู่ชั้นปี4ครับเรียนคณะจิตวิทยาครับเมื่อห้องเรียนแบบนี้ก็ มันก็จะแปลกจากที่เราเคยเรียนมาตลอดชีวิตนะครับผมที่เห็นได้ชัดสุดก็คือเรื่องของการที่มันมีจอที่เยอะนะครับผมแล้วก็มันจะใกล้กับคนเรียนมากไม่เหมือนกับเวลาที่เราเรียนในห้องทั่วไปเนี่ยแล้วถ้าเกิดเราเกเรหน่อยเนี่ยเราไปนั่งข้างหลังเนี่ยแล้วถ้าเกิดเราสมาธิหลุดต่อให้เขาพรีเซนต์อะไรมามันก็เราก็หลุดไปเลยครับอีกอันนึงที่เห็นได้ชัดคือคนเรียนทุกคนนะฮะจะค่อนข้างใกล้ชิดกับผู้สอนเพราะว่าด้วยความที่ห้องมันเป็นตรงกลางนี้ใช่ไหมครับถ้าเกิดคุณสอนมายืนตรงกลางเนี่ยมันก็ยากที่จะแบบแอบไปเล่นเกมฮะหรือว่ามันไม่เหมือนกับห้องที่เป็นห้องลึกเข้าไปแล้วคนไม่คือผมเห็นเลยเพื่อนที่ซีกันเงี้ยทุกครั้งมันต้องไปนั่งข้างหลังพอไปนั่งข้างหลังเสร็จแล้วเนี่ยมันก็อะไรสภาพแวดล้อมต่างๆนะก็ยิ่งช่วยอำนวยให้เขาได้ไม่ต้องเรียนนะครับผมแต่อันนี้มันจะกลับกันครับก็จะใกล้ชิดกับผู้สอน
โอเค soThis is some testimonies from the students. I have to cut it a little bit, though, unfortunately. So in this case, what's happened here is that after some talks, we have the lesson learned that we would like to share is, of course, the environmental have a strong impact on the learning and teachings. For example, in these rooms, you cannothave long lectures anymore. You have to use other techniques, something like that. However, the technology is just a bit of a jigsaw puzzle. You have to integrate both environment, pedagogies, technologies, and also the users. That means both the lecturers, students, administrations, and IT guys, and other things as well, in order to make it work.And then when we talk about smart classroom, unfortunately, I have to say that my room is not smart. It's as smart as the users. So in this case, it's up to the users, really. And the getting the room done is not simple. There's a lot of bureaucracies that we have to overcome. However, we just found that it's just the beginning. It's a lot more.To manage them, to maintain, to make sure that the utilization and everything are effective. So I have to say that it's not just coming to a room, but the infrastructures and the supporting system has to be worked out and adapt to your own situation as well. Okay, this is our.Mottos, three words, 360 degrees, interaction and collaboration. I think that are the key word that the activities is most likely to succeed in the room. You have to have something that is connecting around with the environment, with the others, and in all sorts of angles.Okay, if you're talking about disruptive technology and disruptive innovations, we have to say that it truly became a disruptive innovation when it replaced the existing ones, the existing products and other things. So, well, this is one of the classrooms that we think that it might have a chance or it might not. It's really, we have to just look at the future to see what's happened. And, okay, this is our Facebook page, if you like. usually we try to put something out, some video clips and other things that you might find interesting. Okay, and this is what we do last year.Well, I have to say is that the course is quite expensive and we get the sponsors. This first we get from the Asia Front and then others industries. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rooms altogether. And then the course activities. If you look at these courses, you can see a lot of range in the course. It comes from the first year student,Introduction to Engineering. We have the second year that is lecture-based. We have a lot of designs. We have something for the graduate students as well, seminars. Another thing I think is quite interesting, we can fit a lot of this into the rooms. The idea is that we try to share the utilization by not fixing the rooms to certain classes. Most 3 rooms can be booked throughout the semester if they show that they are going to use active learning heavily. One room is keep for the spares. Other classes or other courses can book for each lessons that they need the features. So in this case, we can make it more. Okay, so that's it. I'm in time. Should be. Okay, I hope that if you have something to ask, please.
Hello, thank you. This is a very nice presentation I have heard. I have a question for you, because actually it's just a simple question, because this is like you try to build a very good environment for education and learning. And however, I noticed that the chair in the room, there's a problem with the leg of the chairs. That has happened. And I think this is also happened in the class in my hospital too. And I don't know whether it used to be caused an accident or not.
Oh, accident. Okay, as far as I know, there's no problem with the chairs. The students, actually they say they like it. They say that they can roll around easily. What will happen is that we once have a problem with the tables. It's a little too light. And then when one lecturer more or less put too much force on it, it just goes crashing down, topple over. So I have to say that the chair is okay. It can move around, and that's what the students like. It can be folded together in one row to move it easily. And that's it.
If I'm going to design the room like this, how much is going to cost us?
more than 1 million. The problem is that we have a lot of, the problem is that we try to do something like the research, because we want to more or less test, iron out the bad things before it was assimilated to other faculties. For example, the tables are designed. They are custom made. The systems for the TVs are very quite complex. We use the bring your own device, so it means that you have to accept both the Apples, the Androids, the PCs, both hardwired and Wi-Fi and wireless and other things. The systems, and we have to wire the wiring around, and it's the length of the wire is quite long, so it can be a lot more expensive, because we have to make sure that the quality, the system qualities are very good, and something, yes, the. Okay, what's next? Yes, we have to do the new panelings. The systems for the power, so that it can be easily shut down, energy conservation, and all other things as well. the paneling for this, the mirrors, paneling for writing. In this case, on the top one that cover the windows, can be slight, so that we have can have a nice thing. So I have to say that we more or less spend a lot more than we have to.
Is there any smart board in this room?
Not in these rooms. The room number 5 and 6 have smart boards. We try to continuously modify the rooms according to the problems that we found. For example, this one has a built-in TV. The top rooms have the movable TV stands instead, or something like that.
Okay, do we have any other questions? Okay, thank you, and thank you to both of our speakers for the afternoon. Thank you everyone for coming, and have a great afternoon. Thank you.